vandag is Wêreldkankerdag en in ons kombuis kyk ons na kossoorte wat kanker veg saam met Andrea Du Plessis. Lekker om jou hier te hê. Hoe gaan dit?
Baie gedankie en jy.
Fantasties. Now, we hear all the stories about how cancer has affected people's lives, but it's good to know that you can actually do something starting off with what you put into your body. Diet is most important.
Definitely. They say you are what you eat. So your body is physically made up of the food components you consume. Mm-hmm. So in general, you can say the healthier the food you eat, the healthier your body will be.
Yeah.
And there are some foods with cancer protective properties. It doesn't guarantee that you won't get cancer. And there are also foods with cancer sort of treatment properties, but it also doesn't guarantee that it will effectively treat.
Yes.
But we've got evidence-based science, and they've done lots of research to show us which foods are the most potent in the cancer-fighting properties. So we've got a nice display here.
Yeah.
And I'm personally in my happy space today because I always say that healthy foods are supposed to taste good and you should enjoy them.
Yes.
So
yes,
I'm going to have this chocolate mousse for breakfast with these berries because evidence-based science says it's good for you.
Okay.
And I know chocolate makes me happy, so
it's a good combination.
It's also good.
Win-win. Yes. Now, when it comes to the nutrient side of things, when it comes to cancer-fighting nutrients, I'm always thinking antioxidants.
That's
antioxidants.
Right.
So rooibos tea.
So you've been paying attention.
I have been paying attention in our classes. But what else is it? What else are we looking for nutrition-wise that is cancer-fighting?
Well, it's a combination of the antioxidants, sometimes the fibers. So if you look at the foods we've got on display here, starting with the chocolate mousse, we know that the cocoa beans are packed with antioxidants, but so too the berries. And you know, the bright colors of the berries are actually those antioxidant components. And they're called anthocyanins. So they give them all these fancy names. But they're really potent antioxidant components.
So other than having your chocolate mousse and berries for breakfast, what else are you looking to get into
your
diet?
Well, you can add some nuts, definitely. These walnuts contain phytosterols. And specifically, the phytosterols have been shown to reduce the risk of sort of breast cancer, where the antioxidants in berries are more linked to prevention of skin cancer.
Okay.
So the different antioxidants also have different target tissues, if you can call it like that, you know?
Okay. Now, looking at this, one of my grandmother's favorite ingredients, the humble garlic, that she would cut up into small pieces and put into a glass of warm water and every night and have a little drink of that. I thought it was dreadful. It just smells But like, why? What's in garlic that is so good for you?
Well, there are many things that are good in garlic, but if we look at cancer specifically, there are nutrients that help reduce the risk of digestive system cancers. So if you're from a family where that is a problem, then it adds benefit to your health to eat garlic regularly. You can take garlic capsules, of course, as well. And fresh garlic is always the best. So garlic is a must on your shopping list.
And a must on my plate every night that I insist on is broccoli, one of my favorite veggies. I like it because it tastes good and you can do so many things with it as well. But what is it about broccoli that is so good?
Well, broccoli contains a component or a group of components called sulforaphanes, and it's obviously linked to the sulfur content. You know, if you boil broccoli, it sort of smells a bit unpleasant. But those fragrances or flavor components in the broccoli are actually also beneficial for your health. And it's good to help in the prevention of digestive system cancers, bladder cancer, breast cancer, and also all sorts of other forms of cancer. Yeah. I forget which other one it is.
Apparently also, if you want to get ripped when you go into the gym,
liver cancer
and if you want to get a nicely cut torso, then you get some of your broccoli in and that'll help you
and
shape
not,
it up.
Then. Not smothered in a cheese sauce, of course.
Oh, man. Okay, so I'm doing that wrong. Okay, so minus the cheese sauce, get that. Tomatoes.
Tomatoes contain lycopene. So the red that you see there in the tomato is called lycopene.
Yeah.
And that specifically has been shown to reduce the risk of prostate cancer, which is specifically important for men.
Ah, yes, exactly. And then tea, lots of tea, green tea, rooibos tea.
If there's something that you need to add to your diet on a daily basis, I would really say green tea or rooibos tea, because both are packed with antioxidants. And specifically, green tea has been shown to reduce the risk of digestive system cancers.
Lovely.
So it's a good thing.
Fantastic. Andrea, thank you very much. As always, we really appreciate your insights and expertise.
You're
and of
welcome.
Course, if you have any more questions, you're welcome to ask those on Andrea's Facebook page, Andrea Du Plessis Vital Expert. I think I'll take this. Bit of this.
Oh, I'll just take this one.
Okay, you do that. You do that. Well, we continue our talk on World Cancer Day by taking a look at something that's made quite the buzz recently, e-cigarettes. Have you heard of those e-cigarettes? Everyone's walking around smoking them, but the question is, you know, are they a better alternative? Are they really healthy? Ilana's find out.
Trust Vital for your family's health.